Welcome back. When it comes to the inside scoop on the NHL, here at Game On, we turn to one man, Rhett McGibbon. And Rhett is back this week, albeit a little under the weather, with another edition of his always popular Rink Report.
Welcome to your NHL Weekly Rink Report, where we take a look at what's going on in the world of hockey. Now, a lot of you at home probably thinking, I'm going to the NHL All-Star Game. I'm not. That game's a joke. I can't stand it. We're going to take a look at some Stanley Cup contenders in the NHL, starting off with our first period, the Chicago Blackhawks. And when you got a guy like Jonathan Toews in the lineup, every given night, you got a chance to win. This guy's the best leader in hockey. Take a look at this goal right here, a top-shelf beauty. This team has extraordinary depth in scoring. They can score from anywhere and everywhere. 9 goals in the lineup with 9 goals or more, and they've also got 5 guys that have double digits. Then you take a look at their goaltender, Corey Crawford. A couple years ago, I didn't think this guy was a goaltender that could potentially lead a team to the Stanley Cup Finals, but he proved me wrong. He did it. Then they got Andrew Shaw. If you like hockey, you gotta love Andrew Shaw. A 5th-round draft pick, this guy can do it at both ends of the ice. He crashes, he bangs, he goes to the front of the net. There are a ton of teams in the NHL that would love to have a guy that can score 20 goals in a season like Andrew Shaw in the bottom 6. And boy, I'd be one of them. He is a great, great player for Chicago and a big reason they are dangerous in the playoff time. All right, second period of play. Let's take a look at another team that you're probably not thinking about when you talk about Stanley Cup contenders, and that is the Nashville Predators. Starting off with their captain, Shea Weber, that beauty of a man right there. He can beat you from all areas on the ice. He'll take you right to the glass. He can pound in the shots. You see right there, he's got an absolute cannon from the point. Now, along with Shea Weber, this team has gone from being just defensively minded to rock and roll. They love to score now, and it starts off with their youngster, Philip Forsberg, who they stole from Washington in a trade. He went from being potentially a draft bust to now one of the best up-and-coming centers in the NHL. Along with that, you got James Neal, who you got from Pittsburgh, so on and so forth. A lot of these guys can put points on the board. Now, my worry about Nashville is the fact that can they win without Pekka-Rinne? I'm going to tell you why him getting injured is a good thing. Adversity is always big when you head into the Stanley Cup playoffs times. And with him being injured, they're learning now to deal with adversity. And if they can start winning without Peck in the lineup, they're going to be in good shape coming in the first round of the Stanley Cup playoffs. And if I was a team going up against them, I would be nervous because Pekka has the ability to steal a playoff series. All right, third period of play, and we're going to go down south. Tampa Bay Lightning, Stevie Yzerman, he is building a dandy down in Tampa. When you got guys like Stamkos, and then you got a guy nobody's even heard of, Tyler Johnson, leading the team in points. He only makes $2.8 million. The core of your team right now is 24 years or younger. That is phenomenal. If you've got cap space to pull these guys in, you are doing some great work, Stevie Y. This team knows how to score. My only worry for them is defensively. Do they have enough depth to make it through the Stanley Cup playoffs? I don't think they do. So what Stevie Y needs to do is he needs to get on the phone, bring in a guy like Franson, perhaps a Sakara out of Carolina, or maybe even Dion Phaneuf. He can work out the cash and you'll be in good shape. Tampa Bay, within the next 3 years, they're going to be in the Stanley Cup Finals. I'm telling you, Floridians down there. Well, that's your NHL Wink Report. I'll send it back to you guys over there.